Me, evil Jeremy, evil Phineas, evil Ferb, evil Candace, evil Stacy, evil Millie, evil Ginger, evil Holly, evil Henry, evil Polly, evil Mrs. Elf, evil King Thistle, evil Isabella, evil Addison, evil Gretchen, evil Queen Thistle, evil Mr. Elf, evil Katie, evil Susie Johnson, evil Ben Elf, evil Princess Holly, evil Daisy, and evil Poppy and I going to watch Tasty Time with ZeFronk.
Time with ZeFronk, we celebrate the beautiful Asian country, Thailand. It is me, ZeFronk, and this is a Thai puppet. Today, we will make a tasty watermelon slash.
Ooh, puppets. I love puppets, Frankie. Can I put on a puppet show for you?
No, Dom, I don't have time for it. Actually, that's a what? I prepare today's snack. You practice with these and put on a show for me and Sue later.
Sure thing. See you later, pal.
Anything to keep him away from my snacks. For my tasty watermelon slush, we need 2 cups of seedless watermelon, 1 tablespoon of honey, and 6 ice cubes. And of course, before we start, we must wash. Wash along with me. We wash our hands to make them neat before we fix our tasty treat. Now, for this treat, we will need to use a blender. Start by having a grown-up put the ice cubes in the machine. Then, we crush the ice. Now, pour in the watermelon and the honey, and finally, we blend it up. And now, we have a tasty, cool Thai treat. Mmm! It is slushy good. And you can make it at home with a grown-up's help. Simply crush the ice, pour in the watermelon and honey, and blend it up. Crush and pour and blend. Hey! Crush and pour and blend. Woohoo!
Hey, Frankie, I'm ready with the puppet show.
Ooh, this I must see.
This is Tasty Time with Frankie. Today, I will be making a tasty treat. Hiya, Frankie. Stay away from my snacks, you silly cat.
You know, it's funny because it is true.
I just want to try some of your tasty watermelon slush. No, Dom, no.
Bravo, bravo, Dom.
You cannot eat my snacks, you pesky cat.
You took the words right out from my mouth.
See you next time on Tasty Time with Frankie.
Out of my kitchen, silly cat. This is Tasty Time with ZeFronk. Today, we bring you a tasty treat from France. Bonjour, everyone. Or as we say in France, oh, that is how we say it in France. Today, on Tasty Time with ZeFronk, we celebrate my home country.
Hey, Frankie, you mind if I paint you?
Paint me?
I've been taking art lessons.
As long as you stay out of the way while I cook.
You won't even know I'm here, pal.
Today, we will be making ZeFronk's famous mini quiche. We will need some bread, 2 eggs, a 1/2 cup of milk, a 1/2 cup of shredded cheese, chopped spinach, salt, pepper, and a muffin tin. But first, wash along with me. We wash our hands to make them neat before we fix our tasty treat. First, we spray the muffin tin with non-stick cooking spray. Spray along with us. Spray, spray, spray. Next, using a cup, we punch circles out of the bread and place the circles into the muffin tin, like so.
Hey, Frankie, hold still. I'm working on your nose.
Now, we break the eggs into a mixing bowl and add the milk.
You can move now.
Phew, thank you. Add a pinch of salt and pepper, and we whisk it all up. Whisk, whisk, whisk. Now, we put it all together. Sprinkle the cheese and spinach on top of the bread. Now, pour the mixture into the muffin tin. And then, ask your grown-up helper to bake it in the oven until golden brown. When they are finished, the quiches will be very hot, so let them cool before you eat. Do I look good?
Yeah.
You can make this tasty treat at home with the grown-up's help. Simply whisk the mixture, pour it in the pan, and bake. Whisk and pour and bake. Hey! Whisk and pour and bake. Oh!
Voila, Frankie!
Dom, you are a very good artist. Ah, but there are only 4 quiches in the painting. There are 6 on my plate, Dom.
I can fix it. How's that?
Much better. See you next time on Tasty Time with ZeFronk. You tricked me out of another snack. Tasty Time with ZeFronk. Today, we bring you a tasty treat from Italy. Welcome to another episode of Tasty Time with ZeFronk. Today, we celebrate the tastes of Italy.
Did you say Italy?
What do you know about Italy, you pesky neighbor cat?
My family comes from Italy. In fact, I happen to be named after my Italian grandpapa, Domenico.
Domenico?
Yeah, and he's coming to visit, and I just know he would love some authentic Italian food.
Well, it would be my honor to prepare a tasty snack for a real Italian. Bring him over when he arrives, Dom.
Will do, Frankie.
Today, we will be making my famous Italian caprese kebabs. So we need some tasty cherry tomatoes, the cute little ones. We also need some fresh mozzarella cheese and a few basil leaves, the toothpicks. Thank you, Sue. But first, we must wash. We wash our hands to make them neat before we fix our tasty treat. Start by carefully sticking the toothpick into a cherry tomato, like so. Then, slide on a cube of mozzarella cheese. Next, take a cute little basil leaf and roll it up nice. Roll along with me. Roll, roll, roll. And we take the rolled up leaf. Finito! We are finished with our delicious snack. Grandpapa Domenico!
Si, that's a me. You must be a little Dom's a good friend, Frankie. My little Dombino said you make a good Italiano treat.
Well, I'm
so hungry from my trip.
Have a caprese kebab, Grandpapa.
Oh.
You can make them at home with a grown-up's help. Simply stick the tomato on the toothpick, slide on the cheese, and roll up the basil leaf. Stick and slide and roll. Woo! Stick and slide and roll. Kebab!
Buongiorno. I'm looking for my grandson, Dom. Have you seen him?
Unfortunately, yes!
Grandpapa!
Buon appetito, Domenico. Arrivederci, Dom.
That means goodbye.
Get out from my kitchen. We'll stir and mix for that snack to fix ourselves a healthy snack. This is Tasty Time with ZeFronk. Today, we bring you a tasty treat from Germany. Bonjour, everyone. Or as we say in Germany, Guten Tag. Today on Tasty Time with ZeFronk, we celebrate Germany.
Hiya, pal. I need your help.
Dom, what is it you want?
I need you to help me practice my German folk dancing.
You?
You bet. I even got the outfit, see? Would you be my dance partner, pal?
I'm busy now preparing my tasty potato pancakes. Go dance by yourself.
Oh, Frankie, German folk dancing is more fun with a partner.
Okay, Dom. After I cook, I will dance.
Danke. That means thank you in German. Oompa, oompa,
oompa. Dom? A German folk dancer? Who knew? Well, to make my tasty German potato pancakes, we need shredded potatoes, an egg, minced onion, salt and pepper. And now it is time to wash up. We wash our hands to make them neat before we fix our tasty treat. Start by putting some shredded potato in a bowl. Then add some minced onion. Next, crack an egg into the bowl. A pinch of salt, a pinch of pepper, and now my favorite part. We mix it all up. Mix, mix, mix. Then ask a grown-up to spoon a dollop of the potato mixture into a heated pan. When one side of the pancake is golden brown, watch as your grown-up helper flips it over. And when the other side is golden brown, voila! You are finished! Mmm! All you need to do is mix the ingredients, dollop them into the pan, then flip! Mix and dollop and flip! Hey! Mix and dollop and flip! Woohoo!
Frankie! Now will you dance with me?
But I don't know how to dance.
Just do everything I do.
And you are sneaking another snack! See you next time on Tasty Time with ZeFronk! Dom! Oh, papa yourself out of my kitchen, you silly cat! Go! ZeFronk! Today, we bring you a tasty treat from... China! Bonjour, everyone! Or, as we say in China, Ni Hao! Today on Tasty Time with ZeFronk, we celebrate China, known for some of the world's most tasty treats. Who can that be?
Hiya, Frankie. This was delivered to me by mistake. It's addressed to ZeFronk. Do you know anyone with that name?
That is my name, you silly cat. Sue, my chopsticks have arrived.
Chopsticks?
Yes, in China and many other places, people use these to eat with.
Really?
You hold them like this and grab the food like so. It takes a lot of practice.
I like learning new ways to eat.
I have an idea, Dom. Take these chopsticks. While you practice, I can make my delicious Chinese chicken salad.
Chicken salad?
For today's recipe, we need iceberg lettuce, mandarin oranges, sliced almonds, chicken, and light sesame dressing. But before we cook, we must wash. Wash along with me. We wash our hands to make them neat before we fix our tasty treat. Thank you, Sue. Start with a big, big bowl. Tear some pieces of lettuce like this and put them in the bowl. Tear with me. Tear, tear, tear. Excellent! Next, layer in the mandarin oranges, the sliced almonds, and some tasty pieces of chicken.
Oh, sorry, Birdie. Ow.
Oh, right, Sue, the sesame dressing. Then we gently toss the salad to mix it all up. Toss, toss, toss. You can make this tasty Chinese treat at home with a grown-up's help. Just tear the lettuce, layer the almonds, oranges, chicken, and dressing, and toss. Tear and layer and toss. Woo! Tear and layer and toss. Yes! Dom!
Oh, you're right, Frankie. Practice really pays off.
Thank you, Dom. Hey, you have sneaked another snack. Oh, well, see you next time on Tasty Time with ZeFronk. Out of my kitchen, silly cat. Jamaica! Bonjour, everyone. Hello, and welcome to another delicious episode of Tasty Time with ZeFronk. We will be making a very tasty treat today. If I ever get this coconut open, whoops! Sorry, Sue. Today, to celebrate Jamaica, we're going to use some island favorites to make ZeFronk's famous coconut banana. banana wheels.
Ahoy, Frankie.
Oh, no. What do you want, Dom?
Frankie, I just found out that my great-great-great-great-great-great-grandfather was Calico Jack Cat.
And who was Calico Jack Cat?
Only the most famous pirate cat to sail around Jamaica. And I'm setting sail in search of his treasure. Anchors away, Frankie.
Finally, I thought that silly cat would never leave. Here are our ingredients for today's tasty Jamaican treat. Bananas, cocoa powder, and a coconut. Ah, shredded coconut. Wonderful idea, Sue. And now it is time to wash up.
We wash our hands to make them neat before we fix our tasty treat.
Now, first, we peel the banana. Peel, peel, peel. Ah, yes, Sue. Always carefully throw away the banana peel.
Hey!
Then, have a grown-up slice the banana like so. Next, roll the banana wheels in the cocoa. Vroom, vroom! Delightful! Finally, sprinkle the coconut on top. Doesn't that look tasty? And you can make it at home. Simply peel and slice the banana, roll it in cocoa, and sprinkle the coconut. Slice and roll and sprinkle. Hey! Slice and roll and sprinkle.
Looks like I found my own tasty treasure.
Dom! You sneaky snack pirate!
Thanks for the milk, pal!
And thank you for opening my coconut! See you next time for another episode of Tasty Time with ZeFronk! Adieu! Goodbye! Out from the kitchen!
Crab! Not the police again.
Evil Yellow Horse. Evil Jeremy. Evil Phineas. Evil Fern. Evil Candace. Evil Stacy. Evil Lily. Evil Ginger. Evil Holly. Evil Henry. Evil Polly. Evil Mrs. Elf. Evil King Thistle. Evil Isabella. Evil Edison. Evil Gretchen. Evil Queen Thistle. Evil Mr. Elf. Evil Katie. Evil Susie Johnson. Evil Ben Elf. Evil Princess Holly. Evil Daisy. And Evil Poppy. You 24 around or less for watching Tasty Time with ZeFronk. You know that show is for babies. You 24 are in deep trouble. Now come with me to the police car right now. Evil Yellow Horse. Evil Jeremy. Evil Phineas. Evil Fern. Evil Candace. Evil Stacy. Evil Millie. Evil Ginger. Evil Holly. Evil Henry. Evil Polly. Evil Mrs. Elf. Evil King Thistle. Evil Isabella. Evil Edison. Evil Gretchen. Evil Queen Thistle. Evil Mr. Elf. Evil Katie. Evil Susie Johnson. Evil Ben Elf. Evil Princess Holly. Evil Daisy. And Evil Poppy. I can't believe you. You 24 will stay in prison until 2825. Now stay. Right now.
Bah.
We all can't believe we all stay in prison until 2825. We will all get really old by then in 2825.
We got the old in killed on it. No parked tester. To be continued on. Bah.